want to talk to you about a general misperception for power. Too many golfers are trying to create power by swinging the club fast. In fact, one of the worst things that's going on in the industry is talking about increasing your club head speed. They're asking you to swing faster, not understanding that how you swing faster is through a much more dynamic action. When we set up into the setup position, what we're doing is we're creating a spring. The spring is based upon the position of our weight and our setup. That spring operates through the torque and the leverage of keeping your weight on your lead side. And how that spring works is off of your upper body. So when I take the club back, my shoulder does not come over here. I do not turn my shoulders to 90 degrees or anything near that. If I did, there is no spring at that point in my body. I've simply turned. But when I do this right here, I'm springing the club off of my back and the position of my torso. I'm creating leverage and torque, which has dynamic action in it. So that when I say to you, just let the club fall, it's not because that's not a powerful thing. It's because there's so much power already in here that you don't have to hit at the ball. You can use the leverage and the torque that's created through the spring of your own body to just simply allow the club to fall in the downswing. And you're going to create more power. It's going to be more consistent, and it's going to be easier to perform because it's really innate with how we use our bodies. It's not foreign. This is not something that we typically do in life, rotate our shoulders and twist our spine. Instead, we get very leveraged in many positions in order to create power. Swinging a baseball bat, swinging an axe, swinging a sickle, even using a broom. You know, there's things that we do with our body that make the object that we're using, the tool that we're using, something that we have leverage over. Well, golf swing's a really dynamic action. It's not like sweeping. It's a very dynamic version of sweeping. So if you can maintain your weight on your lead side, and that requires that this left shoulder's got to stay more on the left side of your body. It doesn't get to come around here. It's got to stay over here. And that's driven by the position of your weight. You don't have to start to become aware of your shoulder. You become aware of your weight. If I'm going to keep the same amount of weight on my lead side, this lead shoulder can't come around me because I've just lost weight there. So I'm going to leave my weight on my lead side, and I'm going to do that from the shoulder down to the foot. And what that does is it creates this spring in my body so that the club will snap back down through. And because of the setup position we have, our club's going to snap back down through on a shallow, circular, and descending swing path, which creates really beautiful golf shots. So when you're trying to create power, this is why I'm so stressed. I stress so much in the school not to swing hard and to trust in the position of your weight and to allow the power to grow. It's because it comes from understanding this position of your weight in order to influence this spring in your hands and arms so that I get to say things like, I don't hit it. I sincerely don't try to hit the ball. My experience of hitting a small chip and hitting driver well over 300 yards is the exact same through impact. I'm not amping up anything and trying to hit at the ball. I'm using the leverage of my body to create this dynamic spring in order to snap the club back down through the ball. Thanks for watching. I know a lot of you are really passionate about your games, and I could tell from the questions that you have that you're trying to learn this swing. I have a solution for you. I have a bunch of really great organized content that will take you through the whole process in a step-by-step manner, with then also a bunch of troubleshooting content that will answer all your questions in all the different disciplines and whatever issues or misses that you're having. And you get me there to guide you through the whole process through email communication and video analysis. So if you really want to improve your game, sign up for my school. You're going to love it. And then make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel to get my weekly videos.